And a pleasant good afternoon, everyone. Jeff Viva, Sports Information Director, Calvin University. I'm going to be bringing you the broadcast of this men's lacrosse match between the Benedictine University Eagles and the Knights of Calvin University. Had quite a bit of snow here in the last 24 hours here in Grand Rapids. And the snow has been successfully cleared from the playing surface. So we're thankful for that. Probably had about 4 inches of snow total yesterday, and a lot of it came late yesterday afternoon. They had a practice that started about 3:30 that got interrupted because of the snowstorm that came in around 4 o'clock, and it just became unplayable with the amount of snow that piled up on this pitch. But it's been cleared and we are ready to play. Another non-conference game for Calvin University. Calvin comes in with an overall record of 5-3. Benedictine currently 1-5 on the year. Benedictine was in action earlier this week. That would have been Wednesday. Lost to Lake Forest 17-7. Calvin was in action on Wednesday and secured a dramatic 10-9 win over Illinois Tech, scoring the game-winning goal in the final 3 seconds. It was freshman Jordan Warners, the man of the hour, who out of a timeout, scoring from the center slot, if you will, going down low and putting the biscuit in the basket. And that was a sweet win, keeping Kelvin above 500 in the one loss column. We will see what transpires here. Benedictine is in the red, cardinal red jerseys, trimmed in black. Kelvin in the white jerseys today, trimmed in maroon and gold. Sun is out. Temps are in the lower 30s. A little brisk, but very playable. And like I said, the snow has been cleared from the field. A year ago, we would not be playing this game on campus. Of course, this area was under construction, but all of the home games for Calvin last year were played off campus, either at local high schools or colleges. So the Knights were a traveling team, if you will, even though they were the home team. And really, for the most part, that had been true for the last several years in these late February and March games where Calvin had an all-natural grass surface. And then here in Michigan, just very difficult to make the pitch playable when you get late winter and early spring. So having a piece of synthetic turf, if you will, on campus has really been a game changer here at Calvin, both in terms of practices for folks like soccer and lacrosse. Baseball and softball has even been out here doing a few practices, as has track and field. I suspect football will get a few practices of some sort on the turf. So just having the all-weather surface, as long as you can get the snow cleared off, has been a huge blessing indeed. All right, take a quick break as we have our national anthem.
At home and abroad. With the singing of our national anthem.
There you have it, our national anthem here at Zytema Field.
And now it's time for
getting ready for this broadcast. This game, Kelvin and Benedictine, has been a semi-annual contest.
From visiting Benedictine University at attack, number one, Ben Zimmerman, a senior.
Just looking up the series history here for you.
Number three, Will Robinson, a senior from Long Lake, Minnesota. Number 25, Luis Hernandez, a sophomore from Billings, Montana. In midfield, number 19, Jonathan Zimmerman, a freshman from Crown Point, Indiana.
So a year ago, these two teams.
Dominic Flores, a sophomore from Denver, Colorado. Number 23, Musa Diallo, a sophomore from Sun Prairie, Wisconsin. In defense for the Eagles, number 36, Cooper Lilich, a junior from Rancho Marietta.
Kelvin won 10-9. That
number
game was
40,
at Benedictine.
Brunken,
it was Kelvin's first win against Benedictine. So no matter how you look at it, Benedictine has won five times against
and
Kelvin.
Goal.
Kelvin has won once against Benedictine.
Doyle, a junior from Commerce,
as I mentioned,
Michigan.
The Knights head coach defeated the Eagles 10-9 last year in Lisle, Illinois. Just looking at game-winning goal scored by Chase Sparling with 1:43 left in that game. In fact, Kelvin got two goals
at attack
in the last
10
minutes of the game to pull that one out.
Number 24, Brayden Carpenter, a sophomore from Noblesville, Indiana. Number 35, a junior,
Corgan Schaumburg will be the goalie for Kelvin. Colin Doyle, the goalie for Benedictine.
For the Knights, number one, Thomas Smith, a junior from Grove Point Farms, Michigan. Number 20, Christian Kohler, a junior from Ionia, New York. Number 28, Jordan Warners, a freshman from Orange, California. In defense, number 13, Micah Vandenberg, a senior from Lowell, Michigan. Number 23, Ethan Bullens, he's a captain. He's a senior from Round Lake, Illinois. Number 25, Dylan Mont. He's a junior from Lindenhurst, Illinois. And in goal to say no for your Kelvin University Knights. MIAA honored. Number 21, Corgan Schaumburg, a senior from Rockton, Illinois. The head coach of the Knights is David Holger, assisted by Bob Evans, Chad Wright, Yevgeny Gevorkian, and Scott Opel. Today's NCAA officials are Brian Effinger, Bert Smith.
Just working off my pronunciation guide. Provided to me by Benedictine's fine sports information director, Tim Calderwood, good friend of mine. Talk about play-by-play. He is near the top of the list when it comes to broadcasters out there. Not only small college athletics, he does some professional minor league baseball, and of course he does all the other items for Benedictine as far as stats. In fact, he has done basketball games where he is doing the broadcast and stats at the same time without a spotter. So he is a very talented individual, and if you're at Benedictine, should feel very fortunate to have a fine sports information director like Tim Calderwood at the helm there. Opening faceoff won by Benedictine. That was Musa Diallo, who came up with a ground ball off the faceoff. And the Eagles on the attack. Going from right to left on your screen is Benedictine. Kelvin going from left to right. First quarter action just underway. Shot by number 30, Dylan Langley, and it's saved by Schaumburg, and the Knights are on the clear. A little bit of a windswept throw, and that's going to be a turnover by the Knights. Well, the ball's going to go out of bounds and be sent right back to Kelvin. Dylan Mount will trigger it for Kelvin. That's Thomas Smith, the junior midfielder out of Grosse Pointe Farms, one of Kelvin's ace scorers, if you will. Can't quite call him an attacker because he plays midfield, but he is frequently in the offensive attack. It's David Blackman. Guy's got good size. He can get in front of the crease and set up as a nice target. He is back behind the net right now. Smith up at the point, slings it out to Christian Kohler. Pass in the center. Oh, and a big collision, and that will be a loose ball. And let's see who comes up with the ground ball. I think that's going to be Benedictine. Benedictine player is down. Knight's called for a push, and that was one of those crunching hits. Benedictine player getting up on his feet. He'll walk off. It's Dominic Flores. We'll shake off that one. So it'll be a clear attempt coming up here for the Eagles. 0-0 is our score. Knights have been involved in a couple of semi-low scoring games last two outings. Lost a tough one to Aurora last week, 7-6. Would have been a week ago today. And then, of course, winning 10-9 the other night at Illinois Institute of Technology. Benedictine in the half-court offense, if you will, turns it over. The Knights on the clear. It was Micah Vandenberg that played a role there. August Bryan and a shot that just goes wide. That will stay with Kelvin. Spinning is Joshua Moyer. Here's a shot from the point. Good save. Loose ball right out in front of the crease. Battle for it. And it's Benedictine that comes out of it. Out of there with the ball. Now a turnover here by Benedictine. Coming right in on net. And a score! That was Riley DeSarbo, the Monroe, Michigan native, who scooped up that loose ball, got the ground ball, and fired it home. And it's 1-0. Young freshman out of Monroe, Michigan. Former home of General George Armstrong Custer. Grew up in Monroe, Michigan. It's a historical museum in Monroe, is my understanding. Kind of a face-off violation on Benedictine. The Knights will get the possession. Christian Kohler has it. 1-0 Kelvin about 3 minutes in to this first quarter. Kohler at the top. Pinching his way in, looking for someone in the slot. No one there. Evan Rohde. Pretty good hit on David Blackman behind the net, and they'll turn it over in that ground ball. We'll go over to the goalie. Nathan Theodorevich, 58, the goalie. Nathan Theodorovic. Sorry, I said his name wrong. Theodorovic. And now another turnover by Benedictine. Nope, it's going to stay with the Eagles. Nope, going to stay with Kelvin. Jordan Warner's the hero from Wednesday night, trying to pinch his way in. Little twist, turn, shot, and just off the goalie's legs and goes behind the net. I think I said Theodorovic is the goalie. It's not actually the goalie. That's one of the defensemen for Benedictine. Now we got a turnover by the Knights. The goalie is actually Colin Doyle. I said that at the outset, too, so correcting myself. Clear attempt here by the Eagles. Joseph Metzger Viome, who was under heavy pressure, it gets it out of a double team, and it is a successful clear by the Eagles. And a loose ball off the hit. It's going to stay with Benedictine. Boy, the Knight defense is really laying some lumber out there, and What do we have here in the call? It's going to be a push on Benedictine, so Calvin will get the turnover and move the ball up the field. Calvin defense much improved this year. Jacob Bledsoe had it. Now Nick Griffith, veteran junior attacker to Geneva, Florida. Now Braden Carpenter has had a good season thus far. In the slot, a shot, and it goes high. Good setup. Bledsoe had it, and it looked like Benedictine was closest to the end line, so the Eagles will get the ball. And we'll have the clear. It's Theodorovic who's got the ball deep, and he's on the clear. Another turnover, it looks like. It is for Benedictine, and then I think the Knights will be called. Well, they're going to say a tip. So Calvin will retain possession. That's Blackman up top there to Bledsoe. Coming right in on that, a shot, and a save, loose ball. Oh, and a wide-open net. A shot for Joshua Moyer. Goes wide of the goal. He's still on it. Joshua Moyer trying to spin his way in. Blackman just bowling his way to the end. And a goal! Stuffs it short side. Bowled his way around the defender and slammed that one into the upper right-hand corner, and it's 2-0 Knights.
Calvin goal, David Blackman.
Face off here. Got Nate Hansen, and Hansen's going to win that one. Nice play to win it against Jonathan Zimmerman of Benedictine. Calvin on the attack. That's Kohler. Wraparound by Carpenter. Right out in front. And a goal. 3-0. And the Knights are rolling. 8 minutes and 2 seconds left. It's Braden Carpenter. Rolling on in. Referees talking something over here.
Calvin goal, Braden Carpenter with a timeout.
Timeout.
From the Eagles.
Taken by Benedictine. So that's what the discussion was about.
We hit terminus!
Calvin volleyball in action. On the men's side, they are down 16-8 in the first set against Mount Union. Swimming and diving. Competing in the prelims this morning, David Bajwa advanced in the 200 backstroke finals, into the 200 backstroke finals out of the prelims. Calvin men's 400 free relay advanced. I think they had the fourth best time in the Calvin women's 400 free relay. Advanced into the championship finals. They took six in the morning prelims. Sydney Sunday is involved in a swim-off to try to get to the consolation final. I think that's going to start about 2 o'clock. She tied for the 16th spot in the 100 free. So in order to swim tonight, she's going to have to swim fast this afternoon. Final day of the NCAA championships. Calvin men currently sitting in sixth place in the team standings. Calvin women, I believe, are in 16th place going into tonight. So here's the face-off. Looks like Hansen for the Knights again. Can't tell if that's Zimmerman again for Benedictine or not. Looks like it is Zimmerman. And a pushing foul on the Eagles. will turn the ball over to the Knights. Blackman will flick it back to Kohler. It's been all Kelvin early on. Benedictine had possession for maybe the first minute or two, but since then it's been all Kelvin. Here's a shot. It's going to be wide and have a crease violation on the night, so Benedictine will get the ball on a clearing attempt. Doyle, the keeper, gets it to his teammate, Jack Dartis. And it will be a successful clear for Benedictine. Eagles in possession there. That was Robert Schroeder. Now Dylan Langley trying to pinch his way in as Schroeder. Now behind the net, Sarna. Twisting, turning. Schroeder again, or Langley, beg your pardon. Little juke, a jive, a shot, and a save. That was Tyler Sarna. Good job by Schaumburg. Battle for the ball. And ball will be turned over by Benedictine. There's the intercept and transition offense right now for Kelvin. On the attack was Enigenberg. Pass goes wide and will stay with the Knights. She was a shot, so thus the Knights able to maintain possession. Nick Griffith with it. 3-0 Kelvin. Got about 6 minutes and change left, first quarter. 6 minutes. DeSarbo, who scored Kelvin's first goal. Ground ball will be credited to Nick Griffith. Got away from the Kelvin player. Ooh, look out, Griffith got sandwiched. Now we're going to have a penalty coming up against Benedictine. Griffith got, they're going to call a trip, looks like. Looks like
Benedictine penalty, Cooper Lillage.
Cooper Lillage with a 30-second penalty, so the Knights of the man up opportunity. Knights of the man up opportunity. Ball right out in front and a goal. A man up goal. That was Kohler. And I think that is that Bledsoe with the assist? Jacob Bledsoe. Yes, it was. So there you have it. Just checking the swimming. Looks like Sydney Sunday did not win the swim off, so she will not swim in the evening. Made it exciting, nice, but lost by
Kohler with the assist from Jacob Bledsoe.
18.18. Pomona Pitzer swimmer coming in at 51.52. She was at 51.70. Face-off violation by Benedictine. The Knights will get that face-off win, so 4-0 Kelvin, 5.5 to go.
If they get another one, they'll start getting penalized.
Really?
Yep. Third face-off violation in any half causes a 30-second.
It ain't man up
automatically. No.
Oh, wow.
Pass in front, and that will go be deflected out of bounds. Bledsoe, looking for some operating room, flicks it back to Griffith. Ball moving around the perimeter quickly. Coming in on net, got poked away and then got the ball back. David Blackman. Very sunshiny afternoon here at Zytema Field. Pass to Bledsoe, flicks it back, then a shot and a nice save by the goalie. Doyle, and the Eagles on the clear. Matthew Brunken brings it over midfield. Pretty good hit on Ben Tankle, but he shakes it off and a successful clear. Tyler Sarna, the junior out of Schaumburg, Illinois. Ball swings around the perimeter here for Benedictine. Ben Zimmerman. About 35 on the shot clock. A little twisting and turning and losing the ball was Luis Hernandez. So it'll be a turnover. And the Knights on the clear. Looks like it will be a successful one. Inigenberg coming right in. And then his pass a little low, scoops away, and it'll be a turnover on the Knights. Little one-on-one challenge, and that's won by Benedictine as they are on the clear. Ben Lafreniere was the man who made it happen there for Benedictine. Here's a shot and a save by Corgan Schaumburg. Luke Grant whistled that one in on net. I think they're going to say that one went wide in the stats. Aiden Elliott gives it to his teammate Luke Grant. Dylan Skura. There's a shot from a tight angle, and that one was saved by Corgan Schaumburg. It'll stay with Benedictine. It will reset the shot clock to 60. Luke Grant, left wing. Now Dylan Skura.
Notice that the size of the field is different for men's?
Yeah.
Last women's.
4-0 Kelvin, late first quarter. Trying to turn the corner and losing the ball. Now we're going to have a penalty, I think, on Kelvin. A push. Yep.
Kelvin, penalty, Brandon Enigenberg. That's a cross-check.
Be on Brandon Enigenberg. So actually looks like a cross-checking penalty. 2:12 left, first quarter. And that will be a one-minute penalty. So Benedictine with the man up opportunity.
There's two different types of penalties, 30 second, 1 minute in normal play.
Near turnover, Benedictine scrambling for the ball. It's going to go out of bounds, and that will stay with the Eagles.
Maybe majors when they get the locked in.
Tyler Sarna up top to Zimmerman. A shot, and it's going to go wide. Benedictine's going to hang on to the ball. 34 in the clock, shot clock that is. 1:45 in the game clock. It's a shot that goes wide, and Kelvin will have possession. Knights are closest to the ball going out of bounds. Getting pretty close to going back to even strength. I think we are at even strength now. Knights trying to clear it, unsuccessful, and scooped up by Will Robinson. Number three, Will Robinson got the ground ball. We're going to have a hold on Kelvin, so Benedictine will hold on to it. Coach Hoger running down the sidelines there trying to protest that call. Showing he's still got some foot speed. Former goalie himself at Eastern University and a shot and a goal. for Dylan Langley, who had a good look at the net and just wound up and cranked it home.
Eagles goal, Dylan.
4-1. Langley. 1 minute left, first quarter. Robinson. Coach Hoger right now pleading his case. He's got his hat off with his arms out. Not going to get anywhere with that one. He's going to have a chat with our lead official right now. So 4-1, faceoff won by Hansen. Kelvin with the ball, and we got a turnover there on Jackson Engbers. And now the Knights get it right back, Christian Kohler. So a couple of turnovers back and forth. 35 seconds left, first quarter. It's Thomas Smith at the top. Got a pass from Jordan Warners. Shot by Smith and blocked by the goalie, a save. Loose ball out on the turf. Battle for it. And I think we've got a push from behind, so 37 of Benedictine will get that ground ball. Jack Dardis, and then a clearing attempt for Benedictine with 5 on the clock. It's like they will clear it, and the pass behind the net, nothing doing there. So at the end of one, Kelvin 4 and Benedictine 1. It's like in volleyball, Mount Union took Kelvin 25-14 in set one. See other sports action here. Kelvin baseball is at Denison right now. See if we can get you an update on that score. Denison, the number 3 ranked team in the country. Track and field is down in Orlando, Florida, at least a collection of track athletes. I think a total of about 20 between the men's and women's programs. And Denison is up 8-1 in the sixth inning, flexing its muscles. The Big Red, 13-2 in the year. Kelvin, 9-7. That's baseball. It's a little Run DMC. Is you ready? Ready? You say you ready? Whole squad ready. Ready? Is you ready? In our background, and we are ready for the opening faceoff of the second quarter. Jonathan Zimmerman for Benedictine and Nate Hansen for Kelvin. Two teams switch sides here. Benedictine going from left to right. Kelvin now right to left. Hansen with a decided height advantage here, and he just bowls his way to that faceoff win. Christian Kohler has it, still on his feet, took a hit, held on to that one, finds Carpenter behind the net. Blackman. Kohler again. Now Warners. Bobbled the ball, and it will be a Kelvin ground ball. Kohler bailed him out. Now it's Thomas Smith. Joshua Moyer out of Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. Or actually, Laura Station, Pennsylvania. Allentown Central Catholic High School. Coming in on net was Moyer. Passes it to Warners. Pretty good ball movement by the Knights. Now trying to hang on to it. That's Blackman. 53 in the shot clock. 4-1. Kelvin leading. Blackman double teamed. Pretty good defensive work by the Eagles. Now Blackman finds a little seam, passes it back to Kohler. Braden Carpenter to Josh O'Moyer, and couldn't hang on to that one. It'll be a turnover by the Knights. Clearing attempt for Benedictine. Good hit, and that'll be a turnover on Benedictine. That was Ethan Bolins, the senior out of Grayslake, Lake, Illinois, forcing Musa Diallo off the ball there, and the Knights get the ball back on the cause turnover by Ethan Bolins. Ethan Bolins. Of course, I've said this before, but Ethan's dad, Eric, was my sweet mate, my freshman year, Calvin. It's always great to catch up with Eric. Pass up top. Knights on the attack, and a little bit of a wayward pass. Ground ball pickup by Carpenter. Riley DeSorbo. Mine's Blackman. Jacob Bledsoe twisting, turning. Goes up top. Loose ball, and picked up there by DeSarbo again. Kind of Kelvin's second attacking line, if you will, in right now. Passing the slot, a shot and a goal. That was pretty. That was Braden Carpenter from DeSarbo, I believe. Nice run into the center of the field, right in front of the net. A little give and go gives Kelvin the 5-1 lead. The Kelvin bench up on its feet. They're dancing a little Saturday Night Live.
From Riley DeSarbo.
Saturday Night Fever, actually. It's the name of that film. Staying Alive, of course, is the song by the Bee Gees. And also the goal song. They're Carpenter. Another face-off win for Nate Hansen. Now the pass goes behind the Knights and a turnover. Here's Benedictine in transition. Look out the other way and a pass out in front. Shot blocked. Race for it as it goes toward the sideline and it'll stay with Benedictine. That shot was by Luis Hernandez. Cross field, a shot and a good save. That was Schaumburg all over it off the shot by Robinson. 12 minutes left, second quarter. Knights up 5-1. Will Robinson will set up shop here. Beautiful sunshiny afternoon here at Zytema Field. Snow has been pushed off the field, and I would guess by Monday most of the snow will be long gone. So we are supposed to get into the 50s with some rain in the early part of the week next week. There's a shot blocked. And a loose ball, scramble for it. Got a flag on the field. Looks like a flag on Benedictine. Kelvin in transition. They have the clearing attempt. That was Ennigenberg racing it into the attacking zone. Joshua Moyer. He's got the ball, waiting for the offensive line to reset. Delayed penalty coming up to Benedictine at this point. Jordan Warners has it. Pass to Thomas Smith and a shot blocked. Probably give a save to the goalie and Kelvin's going to keep it in. 33 seconds left on the shot clock. Kohler to Smith. Smith, a shot from a tight angle, blocked. Ball ricochets to Kohler, and now we've got another penalty flag. As that shot goes wide, we'll see how they sort this one all out. Seems to be some belief there's a cross check on Benedictine for one. They're going to put two in the penalty box. We had the one delayed penalty. So it just looks like a one-minute cross-checking penalty on Dominic Flores.
Could you repeat that second one?
All right, so then that other penalty, the push on Langley, which I think was the delayed penalty, also is enforced. So now it's a two-man man-up situation for Calvin. Two in the box for Benedictine, one for 30 and the other for 60. 5-1 Kelvin, 10:29 left, second quarter. Coming right around that corner and a shot saved. That was Bledsoe with a shot. Colin Doyle has been a busy man in the goal there for Benedictine, came up with that save. Pass handcuffed Carpenter for a moment. Now it comes back to Bledsoe. In the slot, Moyer trying to get there. In the crease, and it's sent out wide. And just picking it up. Looks like Benedictine will pick it up. So that will kill off one of the penalties. Knight still with one man up situation.
Yeah,
Kelvin called for being in the crease there, so they had to let the ball go. Benedictine was glad to just let time run off. Clearing attempt for Benedictine. Oh, and a big hit laid by Blackman on a little talking going on there. Robert Schroeder got nailed by Blackman. Kelvin with the turnover. Cause turnover on Benedictine, and the Knights have it. A shot, and it's going to go wide by Smith. Kelvin maintains possession. Bledsoe, he'll crank it from an angle and deflects off the goalie's pad and a save. Loose ball still out there. Knights scoop it up. That was Kohler on the ground ball. Here is Smith. A shot from up top, and deflected wide again, I believe, by the goalie, Doyle. It looks like we are at even strength now. Pass out in front. Little backhanded shot goes wide by Moyer. Not sure if they credited that as a save or not. I'm just going to call it wide. 8:50 left, second quarter, 5-1, Calvin. Kohler. Pass to Carpenter. Finds Smith. Lost it. Be a cause turnover by Nathan Osborne, number 22. 22 with the turnover in the ground ball. Be a clear attempt by Benedictine. Oh, and I think we're going to have call a penalty or just a push? Just a push, so Benedictine hangs onto the ball. That is Schroeder with it. Will Robinson trying to turn on in. Pass into the slot. Nothing there. Collision. Ball on the turf. That's Benedictine with a ground ball. Hernandez. We get a timeout taken, I believe, by Benedictine.
Timeout Benedictine.
Still 8-1 in the baseball game. Calvin trailing Denison, first of two. Volleyball, Calvin trailing Mount Union, 19-14 in set two. And here at Zytema Field, Calvin 5 and Benedictine 1. Goals scored by DeSarbo, Carpenter, Kohler, and Blackman. If I stole somebody else's wave to fly. Missing one other goal there. Just looking at the stats. Two goals for Carpenter. That's what I thought. Get no win. So I think I gave you a whip around of Kelvin sports today, swimming and diving at the national meet, concluding competition, 4 days of it. They're in Greensboro, North Carolina, track and field in Orlando at the Central Florida Night Invitational, baseball at Denison, men's lacrosse here against Benedictine, and men's volleyball is at home right now against Mount Union. I think I got them all. Benedictine on the attack. Dylan Langley. Wayward pass will be a turnover. The Knights will get it back. That is McKinney, Chuck McKinney, coming right down the chute. Just bounced right off a Benedictine midfielder. Out of Mission Viejo, California, Trabuca Hills High School grad. Twisting and turning is Griffith. Now it's DeSarbo again. Knights have dominated this game. And dominating possession, a shot, and saved by the goalie. That was Bledsoe. Four shots now for Kelvin. 11 for Benedictine. That's Blackman trying to just weave his way in on net. Instead, gives the ball back to DeSarbo. Nick Griffith. Twisting, turning, Bledsoe. A shot, and I think that one went wide, so we'll stay with the Knights as Bledsoe was spilled to the ground. The good thing when you're Bledsoe is, well, you're about 5'8". So you can weave your way in there. Time runs out on the shot clock, so it'll be a turnover. The bad news is that you can take a pretty good hit sometimes, too, by a bigger player. Benedictine Will Robinson with it, trying to push in on net. Find Zimmerman, and now Aiden Elliott, sophomore out of Conifer, Colorado. Pass in the slot, a shot, and that was Zimmerman. I think Schaumburg got a little piece of it. Recently named MIAA Defensive Player of the Week, Corgan Schaumburg. Pass to the top, a shot and a goal. I believe that was 32. Robert Schroeder with the assist.
Eagles
and Tyler Sarna with the goal from up top. It makes it 5-2.
Robert Schroeder.
Is it Schroeder or Schroeder? I don't have a pronunciation. We'll look up. Look that one up here a minute. Schroeder is the way to say it. Robert Schroeder. Nate Hansen in the faceoff area. Loose ball, and that will be won by Kelvin. Ground ball was secured by Drew Garrison, who is in. Getting some minutes. Behind the back pass, and a shot by Joshua Moyer. At the behind the back feed from David Blackman, and from a tight angle, Joshua Moyer, the Allentown Central Catholic High School graduate, puts the biscuit in the basket, and his teammates are up on their feet applauding. 6-2. Joshua Moyer himself, a communications digital media specialist with a highlight reel goal, and the Knights up 4.
Calvin Gold, Joshua Moyer with the assist from David Blackman. Hockey assist, Nate Hansen.
Hansen on the faceoff here, going on again against Zimmerman. And that will be won by Benedictine. Will Robinson with a ground ball. Got a glove down. Calvin Player lost his glove. Or is that the Benedictine player lost his glove? It was Will Robinson. 5 minutes left, second quarter. Pass up top, Sarno just scored a goal a bit ago. Finds Aiden Elliott. Now Zimmerman being pressured tightly by Chuck McKinney. Elliott. Pass on the ground. Will Robinson trying to pinch his way in from the right flank. This pass will go to... and a shot and a goal from deep. Schroeder. Beg your pardon, it's Zimmerman with the goal and Schroeder the assist.
Eagles goal.
Another one from deep.
The assist from Robert Schroeder.
Makes it 6-3. So Kelvin defense getting a little leaky suddenly. Hansen and Zimmerman again. There's two Zimmermans, Jonathan Zimmerman and Ben Zimmerman. I suspect they are brothers, both out of Crown Point, Indiana. Crown Point High School grads down near the lake shore as you're going through that little bit of Indiana into the Chicago, Illinois area. That faceoff won by Hansen and up with it is Kohler. Kohler, the junior out of Ionia, New York. Got a ask him how to say his high school. I think it's Honeoye Falls Lima High School. I always do the copy and paste when I do the hometown high school with him.
It was a rough timeout for some reason.
Stoppage of play. And we'll restart it with Kelvin in possession. Didn't quite see what happened there. We are in the construction trailer, so sometimes our vision is blocked. So I didn't quite see what happened in the corner. I can tell you Kelvin hung on to possession. Thomas Smith working with Jordan Warners. 6-3 right now. Kelvin on top. 3:40 left here in the first half. Carpenter. Pass up top. And it comes bounding to the... feet of Christian Kohler, now Smith turning, shooting, and it's wide. That will stay with the Knights. 24 in the shot clock. So that half-court offense starting to stagnate a little bit for Kelvin. Pass into the middle. Ground ball, Kohler a shot. Nice save by the goalie, Doyle. And Benedictine will take over on the clear attempt. Going to be a turnover by the goalie. He got pressured, and Ethan Boland scooped it up. A shot from in close by Carpenter. It's blocked. Battle for it. Still a battle for it. Carpenter trying to get there. And that was Justin Riddle who came up with it for the Knights. And a timeout taken by Kelvin with 2:35 left. Second quarter / first half. Got 62 on the shot clock.
Get the horns up.
Kelvin offensive coordinator. Chad Wright will try to reset this one. So Knights had the possession.
Oh, God.
got to pump it up, don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up, don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up, don't you know, pump it up. You've got to pump it up, don't you know, pump it up.
And right now, with Kelvin up 6-3, they're trying to reset the offense. They're trying to pump it back up. It's like a second set volleyball. Mount Union up 22-20 on the Knights. Baseball now, 8-3 in the seventh.
Woo! It's go, 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 go time. Tick, tick, boom. We're bringing the noise. Go, baby, we bringing our toys. Separate me from the boys. Chopper be singing, she'll be on the voice. Bang, bang, we gon' ride out. Gang, gang, we on.
Kelvin on the attack. Pass from Blackman behind the net. Trying to pinch in was DeSarbo and got sandwiched. Ball comes back to the Knights. Nick Griffith will find DeSarbo. Looking for something in front. His shot will go wide. Stays with Kelvin, 33 in the shot clock. 2 minutes, 6 seconds left, game clock. Bledsoe.
2 minutes and a half.
And now DeSarbo. Pass deflected, comes back to DeSarbo. 15 on the shot clock. Thomas Smith, shot goes way wide. And Benedictine comes up with it. Eagles on the clear. Be a turnover. Unsuccessful clear. Be a turnover on the goalie, Doyle. So Kelvin will reset. Almost can run out the clock. About 10-second difference between game clock and shot clock. DeSarbo. Pass out front and a shot and a nice save. That was Carpenter. Nice setup, and Doyle the save, and then another crank. Grab a foul on Benedictine, or did we get a timeout? So it will be a timeout for Kelvin after they had just gained possession, or regained possession off the rebound shot. See if I can look up the amount of saves that we have seen in this first half. Colin Doyle has been busy. Twelve saves for Doyle in the first half. Ready to go here. Coming down the final minute or so of the first half. Shot from a tight angle. Blackman blocked in the rebound and a goal by Christian Kohler. Went from the right side to the left side, and Kohler was able to get the rebound, had an opening, and slammed that one home. little fist pump action. 7-3 with 54 ticks left. And Knights could go for more if they can win this faceoff and set up for one more attack. Nate Hansen going up against Jonathan Zimmerman. Face-off won by Hansen. And slides it over his teammate Austin Bryan, junior out of Elburn, Illinois. He'll stay in the attack for the Knights. August Bryan trying to weave in. We've got 30 on the game clock. Smith twisting, turning, hanging onto the ball. Pass saved there by Bryan. 20 on the shot, game clock. In essence, a shot and game clock, if you want to call it that. We're going to have a turnover by Kelvin. Pretty good hit leveled on Joshua Moyer. And the goalie comes up with it. Doyle, loose ball, and not sure if they're going to call that a shot or not by David Blackman. Can tell you at the end of one half a play, it's Kelvin 7 and Benedictine 3. We'll take a little break, and we'll be back with more start of the second half and stats. Stick around.
Hey, okay. Now, today it is here. Welcome to Grand Rapids Christian High School, where today the curtain does rise on Calvin University football.
We've been dreaming about this our whole lives. The whole world's been wondering, what is Calvin football, right? What is Calvin football? Today, men, we get to show it. Let's go turn this thing up, man.
Here come the Knights. Drake back to throw out of the gun as Pryor lofts it in the end zone. And touchdown. Teeter to Kreider. 20 seconds to go. Pryor again avoids the rush. He goes to the end zone. And it is a final touchdown. Hunter Hogan on the jump ball. Skied.
Texas on three. 1, 2, 3. Touchdown.
Ladies and gentlemen, we look forward to welcoming you back here next Saturday, March 30th at 1 o'clock when the Calvin Knights continue non-conference play against the North Central College Cardinals from Naperville, Illinois. We'll see you here at 1 o'clock next Saturday.
Feeling, we're dancing on the field.
All right, ready to go here. Kelvin leading 7-3, third quarter underway. And Nate Hansen knocking that one free, wins the faceoff, and it's Kohler with a ground ball. Good start of the second half for the Knights. I think we have a new goal. Do we have a new goalie in? We do have a new goalie in for Benedictine, number 8. So James McDonald is in goal for Benedictine. Jordan Warners behind the net. Will Robinson, or Robinson defending. Carpenter to Joshua Moyer, playing point. Little dipsy do, a shot, and it's going to go way high into the snowbank. Playing with the orange lacrosse balls today, allowing them to be able to find balls like that that go into the snow. Here's a wraparound shot and a save. That was McDonald, the new goalie, freshly in, makes the save. And that is Nathan Theodorovic. Theodorovic, that's how you say it, sorry. I'll look at the pronunciation guide again. That's Ben Zimmerman. And I believe we have a successful clear for Benedictine. Eagles going from right to left here in the third quarter. Sun continuing to pour out. Have a real nice crowd here at Zytema Field. Was just out there looking. A lot of fans have filled in. Robert Schroeder being pestered by August Bryan. That pass will be picked up off the ground by Tyler Sarna. So the Eagles still in possession. Spinning Ben Zimmerman. Pass out in front. A shot and a wide open net and a goal. That is Will Robinson from number 1, Ben Zimmerman. And Zimmerman paid the price on that pass. Got real crouched up and just belted by the defender. So sacrifice for the team. And he is still a little slow to get up. Looks like he's going to stay in there and be all right. 7-4. So Benedictine drawing first blood in the second half. Still a 3-goal lead for Kelvin. Face off here. Hansen and Jonathan Zimmerman. And another win for the sophomore out of Naperville, Nate Hansen. Jackson Engbers into the game, young freshman out of Highland Christian. Feeds it over to DeSarbo, another freshman. So some youthful talent coming into the Kelvin lineup here. Good sign for the future. Joshua Moyer splitting two defenders right in a net and a shot. Oh, I thought that was behind the goalie, and it just deflected off of the legs there of McDonald. Knights trying to hold on to possession, could not. Ball be turned over to Cooper Lillick. And a clear attempt for Benedictine. Ben Tankle through the left wing, and a clear attempt will be successful for the Eagles as Ben Zimmerman circles in. Kelvin baseball, Knights are down 8-5 in the eighth inning in game number 1 against Denison. Here's a shot out in front, and that will go wide. That was Schaumburg who deflected it wide. I think it was Sarno with a shot. Twisting, turning, Dylan Langley. Now it's Schroeder. 29 on the shot clock. Pass out in front, never got through to, not sure who that's 25, Luis Hernandez, and it goes wide. We got a flag on the field. I think a penalty coming up to Kelvin's Ethan Bolins. This will be a man-up opportunity for Benedictine. Chance to creep to within 2. 1 minute penalty, unnecessary roughness on Ethan Bolins. 7-4, Kelvin in the lead, 11:08 left, third quarter. It's like Mount Union has just wrapped up a three-set win over the Kelvin men's volleyball team. 25-14, 25-21, 25-18. Turnover there by Benedictine. And Kelvin on the clear attempt. Down a man, transition offense, August Bryan. Coming right down the field, check from behind. Ball knocked off his stick, comes to Kelvin, oh, and a goal! Assist was number three. I think that was Braden Carpenter, 24, with a goal. Number three had the assist. So that will be Blackman, number three, with the assist. And Braden Carpenter with a hat trick.
That's a hat trick for Braden Carpenter with the assist from David Blackman.
That is a big goal. Knights down a man. They get the turnover transition offense.
Here's a noise for your Knights.
They make it 8-3. Hansen again against Zimmerman. Hansen has been dominant in the faceoff circle. Scoops up another one. Gets his own ground ball off the win. Gets the ball over to Blackman. 8-4, beg your pardon. There's a chance Benedictine to get to within two with a man-up opportunity, and they turn it over and the Knights score. So a big sequence of events. Knights still down a man, too, but winning that faceoff, able to kill off the penalty time and maintain possession. And we are even up. So Thomas Smith joins the fray. Good move by Kohler and a goal. Oh, my. He even juked out his own man, Josh Moyer. Moyer might have fallen down on purpose as he was in the shooting lane of Kohler. So he just kind of fell down and off the juke move by Kohler, and he fired it from the left wing. And that, I believe, is his second goal.
Not to be outdone by the freshman. Kohler wanted a hat trick.
Well, that's a hat trick. Yeah, I thought it was potentially his hat trick. So 9-4. So a couple of hat tricks going here for Kelvin. Another face-off opportunity. Battle for it. Hansen just goes in the scrum and gets on his knees and picks that one up. And here comes Kelvin again. Jackson Engbers, the midfielder, wins that one. His father, the athletic director at Highland Christian High School. And his uncle, the athletic director at Unity Christian High School. So I always enjoy chatting with both Engbers brothers. See them a lot. Of course, they're both Kelvin alum out of Whitensville Christian High School. Dave, the father of Jackson, here's a shot, goes wide, played lacrosse here at Kelvin, and of course Jeff Engbers, the uncle, the one at Unity, was an All-American track and cross country runner at Kelvin. And then another brother, Jeff Engbers, played a little basketball. Here's a shot by Blackman, saved by the goalie. And a clear attempt coming up for Benedictine. Long clearing pass, and that will be a successful clear. That was McDonald finding Dylan Langley up ahead. So here comes Benedictine. 9-4. Kelvin has answered with two straight goals after Benedictine had brought it to within three and had a man-up opportunity. Pass intercepted. Bolins, Ethan Bolins, causes the turnover and snags it out of midair. Clearing attempt for Kelvin, and here come the Knights. That is Engbers again. finds Thomas Smith. Actually, I think that was Engenberg, not Engbers. Knights holding on to possession, 7:40 left in this third quarter. Pass up top, snagged, and a shot, and it goes wide by Joshua Moyer, or beg your pardon, Jacob Bledsoe. Jordan Warners finds Bledsoe. A shot from the point goes wide. Thomas Smith trying to sneak it near side. 23 in the shot clock. 7:17 on the game clock. Warners again coming in on net. Passes it far side. Smith a shot and it's deflected. Blocked by a defender. And it will stay with Kelvin, but just 10 on the shot clock. Knights will have to act quickly. Warners tries to find Smith, and that one will go out of bounds, be a turnover. So Benedictine will go to the other way. Here come the Eagles. Robert Schroeder finds his man Langley. Now Aiden Elliott. Back to Langley. Elliott got the ball turned over, and here comes Kelvin in transition. Joshua Moyer working in tandem. Pass out in front, trying to go short side, trying to stuff it in with Blackman, could not, blocked. It'll be a clearing attempt for Benedictine. It's Dylan Skura, I haven't said his name so far. Benedictine clears it. About 6 minutes, well, 5:40 actually, left here in the third quarter. Pass goes wayward, a turnover, and Kelvin will get it right back. Clearing attempt. 5.5 to go, third quarter. Kelvin up 9-4. Ethan Bolins. That is Bledsoe now. The feed from Micah Vandenberg. On the carry right now is Nick Griffith, Florida native. Pass in the slot, a shot goes wide. Looks like that was Braden Carpenter who had the shot. Nope, check that, Joshua Moyer. So a clear coming up for Benedictine. The goalie McDonald with it. They find Schroeder. His pass deflected, comes to his own teammate Tankle. Looks like we're going to have a successful clear. Elliott has it. Now Ben Zimmerman tossing it around the horn. Dylan Langley. Pretty tight defense by Kelvin's Titus Holloman. Here's a shot and a good save by Corgan Schaumburg, acrobatic save up in the air. He gets the ground ball, and here comes Kelvin on the clear. Ethan Bolins finds his teammate Titus Holloman, the sophomore out of Grand Rapids South Christian High School. Clear attempt is good, and now Warner's working with Thomas Smith. Kohler, three goals for Christian Kohler today. New York native looking for operating room. Goes up top to Smith. A big swipe on Joshua Moyer. Hangs onto the ball. Flag down and a shot and a goal. David Blackman scores, and I think that was 35. Moyer the assist.
You're way too beautiful, girl. That's why it'll never work.
They'll wave off the penalty after that goal.
Suicidal, when you say it's
10-4. Calvin on top with 3:11 left second or third quarter.
Eagles penalty was waved off by that goal.
Face off again, Hansen and Zimmerman. And it's one. By Calvin's Hansen, and then ball on the deck, picked up by Dylan Mount of Calvin. Here come the Knights. That's Engbers with it. Finds Carpenter. Pass out front, a shot. That was Brian. He got hit as he was releasing it. Saved by the goalie. Calvin resets the offense. Jordan Warner's. 2.5 to go, third quarter. Calvin still in possession. Smith looking for a shot, looking for Blackman. Stead shoots it wide. Stay with Calvin, 34 in the shot clock. 2:08 on the game clock. Third quarter here. Glad to have you along for this broadcast. Jukin jiving. Joshua Moyer still moving in. Goes down on the ground. Loses the ball. The turnover was caused by number 9, Nate Hansen. Number 9, Ben Lafreniere. Didn't quite see who got the ground ball. For Benedictine, I think it was Ben Tankel. And a clear attempt is good for Benedictine. Ben Zimmerman circling, finds Dylan Skura. Pass is intercepted by Christian Kohler, and the Knights in transition on the break, right down the chute. Christian Kohler will clear it for the Knights, and they are on the attack with just over a minute left, third quarter. Blackman.
1 minute.
Being checked there by Theodorovic. Ooh, look out. Losing the ball momentarily was Griffith. Got it back. Bledsoe. Under a minute to go. Finds Blackman. Thought about shooting. Hangs on to it. Tight angle! And just wide. Hit the outside of the net and picked up by the goalie, number 8, McDonald, and Benedictine on the clear. Carpenter pressing on defense. Trying to make life difficult for Benedictine. Long bomb pass and deflected onto the ground. It'll be a turnover by the goalie, McDonald. And there's a shot in transition. No, another shot, and that one is good. A goal for David Blackman on the rebound shot.
35 save, goal 3.
And that comes with just 4 seconds left. So another goal. For Blackman.
There's a hat trick for David Blackman.
So 3 hat tricks going. That's his hat trick. Christian Kohler's got a hat trick. And I think that's Braden Carpenter who also has a hat trick right now. And there's the horn.
You score at the end of three.
End of three.
Now the Knights, 11.
Knights up 11-4.
Eagles, 4.
Getting a text from our swim coach. Right now the projection line is the Calvin men with the swimmers that they have tonight. Calvin men projected to take six in the final team standings, which if it holds, would be the highest ever national team finish in Calvin men's swimming and diving history. Calvin women took fourth, I believe, in 2007. In fact, just talking about the Engbers clan, Jeff Engbers, beg your pardon, the youngest Engbers brother. So got to think of his first name, but he's the one who played basketball, and I'm jumping around. But his wife, Erica Duer, was a national champion diver on that Calvin women's team that took fourth back in 97. And the Calvin women are projected to finish 13th right now, which would be a nice bump up from where they finished last year. I think it was 18th. So Hansen against Zimmerman again. Face off won by Calvin, and the ground ball comes to Engbers. Right down the middle, Christian Kohler. Shot from a tight angle wide by Joshua Moyer. The goalie McDonald has it. Clear attempt coming up. Theodorovic has it. Here come the Eagles. Ben Zimmerman. Clear attempt will be good for the Eagles. Benedictine in possession, right out in front, never really got a clean shot off. Trying to catch it and shooting it at once as Ben Zimmerman didn't quite come off. Ground ball comes to Calvin Knights on the clear attempt. Tossing it is the goalie, Corgan Schaumburg, who came way out of his net. Now Bledsoe. Blackman. Theodorovic on him. Pass behind the net. Ball going around the horn. DeSarbo. Now Moyer. Pass through the middle, never got through. Toward the sidelines and out of bounds. Carpenter trying to chase it down. Be a turnover for the Knights. 12:55 left, fourth quarter. 11-4. Calvin has reeled off four straight goals after Benedictine had got to within three at 7-4. Pass comes to Cooper Lilich. And it's a clear attempt. successful for Benedictine. Shot from a tight angle, and it goes wide of the net. That was Schroeder. Benedictine will maintain possession. Schroeder. In possession of the ball. Being defended by Eli Bolins, the younger brother of Ethan. Pass to the far point and intercepted, I think. Let's hang on here. Loose ball, and it is Eli Bolins comes up with it. Now we have a hold, I think, on Kelvin. So actually the ball will stay with Benedictine. Pass through the center, deflected. Ground ball, battle for it. Benedictine for a moment, but come behind the goal, and that is Micah Vandenberg.
So, yeah, it was ground ball 15, turnover 15. Okay, I don't know who caused it.
Micah's younger or older sister, I should say, Jamie Vandenberg, real outstanding player in the women's team for a number of years. See her at the games every now and then. Going to be a turnover on Benedictine. A little miscommunication with Ben Zimmerman and his teammate along the sideline, so Calvin will get it back. Intercepted. Pass by Smith. Picked off. So a failed clearing attempt. Now on it is Dylan Skura. Dylan Langley, twisting, turning, a shot snared out of the air by Corgan Schaumburg. Clear attempt, here comes Calvin. August Bryan in transition, Ennigenberg, maybe a chance for a shot, and he'll pull it back out, and the Knights will reset. Kohler. It's Braden Carpenter, 50 on the shot clock, 10:08 on the game clock. Pass behind the net. Smith with a shot. I think the goalie might have gotten a little piece, not sure. Or it just went wide. Kelvin has possession. Thomas Smith, nice move, pass behind the net. Coming in, tight angle, shot, goal! Braden Carpenter from Thomas Smith. That makes it 12-4. That should be the fourth goal for Carpenter.
That's a fourth goal for Brayden Carpenter with the assist today from Thomas Smith.
So Carpenter, the sophomore to Noblesville, Indiana. Face off here. Hansen again against Zimmerman. And again, it's the Diesel Hansen who comes up with that one. Another face off win and another ground ball. Oh, he took a big hit. And a penalty will be called on Benedictine. A little bit of a cheap shot there. And again, Berg with it. Passes it to Blackman. Might be a little bit of a frustration foul at that point on Benedictine. Score starting to get away from the Eagles and a lot of face-off wins by the Knights. Here's a shot from a tight angle wide. That was Ryan Wester, I believe, getting some playing time, and now that penalty will be enforced. And I guess that'll be a cross check. See if it's 30 or 60. It's like 37 will be the player. Jack Dardis will get the penalty.
On Jack Dardis, 1 minute cross check.
And that cross checking penalty will be a 60-second penalty. So a man-up opportunity for Calvin. They've already scored one, a man down. Oh, they're going to say unnecessary roughness. A two-minute penalty. And a goalie switch for Calvin. Tristan Windham, the sophomore to Parker, Colorado, will go in for the Knights.
Goalie for Calvin Knights, Tristan Windham, freshman from Parker, Colorado.
All right, getting that one sorted out. So not sure if that's an unreleasable penalty, if it's a 2 minute. Yeah, so an unreleasable. So he'll be in for the full 2 minutes. Blackman swinging it around. Joshua Moyer. Knights just looking for the open space. A shot from a tight angle goes up and over the goal. That was Blackman looking for his fourth goal of the day. Then Blackman, Kohler, and Braden Carpenter have really provided a lot of the scoring shot from a tight angle. A nice save by McDonald, the goalie. 23 on the shot clock. Pass up top. Deflected. Comes to Carpenter. Kohler now. Pass behind. A shot going to go wide. That was Bledsoe into the snow. Kelvin still has possession. 10 on the shot clock. A couple seconds ran off that shot clock. So it's down to 8. And they'll have to reset it. So they do not have a whole lot of time. To the top. Being patient. Kohler a shot. And I think that was deflected, not a save. Wasn't on goal, so Benedictine comes up with the ball, tries to clear it. Loose ball on the deck. And it's still Benedictine with it. Theodorovic. They'll clear the zone. Down a man, and look out. Here comes Benedictine, and going down on the turf was Will Robinson. We're going to have a penalty coming up to Calvin. Robinson picking up that ground ball, being checked tightly from behind by Josh Sutton, who is into the game. Sophomore out of Ultawa, Tennessee. Just a guess on how you say Ultawa, Tennessee. My son's in the press box. He was down in Tennessee a week ago. Maybe he can help me out. Well, he has no idea either. Not sure if it's near the Smoky Mountains or not. I can tell you, Tennessee women's basketball, Lady Vols had a big win in the NCAA tournament today, first round.
Now the penalty on Josh Sutton, that's 1 minute for a slash.
So that penalty will be on Sutton. He'll get the 60-second slashing penalty. So we are even as far as players on the field. Should be 9 apiece right now. Start getting to, NHL playoff hockey where they go 3-on-3 in the overtimes. That always is interesting. Shot and a goal. That'll be an even strength goal. That's 3 from 32. Will Robinson the goal in number 32. Robert Schroeder the assist.
That's Will's second goal.
First goal for Benedictine since the early moments of the third quarter. 6:46 to go on this one now, 12-5. Baseball was just about done in game number one, and it is now a final. Denison 9, Kelvin 5. They'll play game two in about 20 minutes. New man in the faceoff circle for Kelvin, and the Knights win that one. That was Evan Rohde against Zimmerman. The Knights win the faceoff. Pass will go out of bounds, though. Turnover. Benedictine with 6:33 to go will get a chance to clear it. McDonald, the goalie, here in the second half, tosses it to Theodorovic. Kind of a methodical push up the field by the Eagles. Pretty good hit there by Inigenberg. And Inigenberg deflects that one, causes a turnover, and a ground ball to number 18, a Kelvin, who loses it. That was Ryan Arn, and then he turned it over. And a shot and a goal. It'll be number two from three. Number two, the shot, Skura, and three, Robinson, the assist. So that's where life comes at you fast. Kelvin caused the turnover, and then Benedictine caused the turnover right back, and in transition, scored the goal. Trying to remember who that turned it over for Kelvin there. Anyway, faceoff won by Benedictine, 19, and then a turnover caused by 11. And he got his own ground ball. Drew Garrison, freshman out of Columbus, Ohio. Worthington Christian graduate. Good to see some of these youngsters in the game getting playing time, building that depth and the squad for the future. Into the game is Theodore Hollebeek, another freshman. He's out of Holland Christian High School.
He's been on IR for a long time. He just got released. It's his first game back, Jeff.
First game of the year, I understand, for Hollebeek. And rehabbing from an injury. So good to see him back on the field. Pass in the middle. A shot, and it's going to be saved by, I think that was Blackman again, who came up with that ground ball and then had the shot. Now we got a big scrum and a bunch of whacks. There were some bodies that got hammered by a stick, and let's see who is the guilty party for the slash. I mean, you just had a loose ball with about five bodies, and somebody came from the outside and just went with a big slash of the stick. Is that going to be Moyer, the guilty party for the slash? Yeah, he's not in the penalty area. Or maybe, yeah, I guess he is in the penalty area. So Josh Moyer, 60-second penalty. .452 to go here in this one. On the attack is Benedictine, Tyler Sarna. So a man-up opportunity for Benedictine. Down 12-6 right now, trying to tighten this one up. Still not over. Nice defensive play and an intercept. That was Ethan Bolins, and he just drew a penalty on Benedictine. He got slashed in the face. Passes it through the center. That's Justin Riddle. Be a good clear attempt for Kelvin, well, look out. And I think that's Chuck McKinney got knocked down, lost his stick, and little pushing and shoving going on here. And I think we've got a penalty coming up to Benedictine, maybe a second penalty. I'll try to sort it out. I think we have a slash for the first penalty and an unnecessary roughness for penalty number two. So Kelvin will be up a man. I think two players out for... All right, so just even up. So just calling that 60-second slash. No unnecessary roughness infraction. 4:18 to go. Twelve to six. The Knights have doubled up the Eagles of Benedictine. Thomas Smith to Kohler.
What's your sports photographer's name here?
Got Ashley Sapp, our photographer, here today. There's a shot, Blackman, and a nice save by McDonald. Scoops it up off the ground. Here comes Benedictine. Long bomb pass, and it's successful to Elliott. They clear it, Benedictine. Pass down on the turf. Now, it looked like a turnover on Benedictine, but I think they got a timeout called before that pass went away. So they will maintain possession. The clock will stop with 3:33 left. So we get a little David Bowie to serenade us here. The late, great David Bowie.
So this was a request.
Sang this song with Freddie Mercury of Queen, who was also on this, the late and great Freddie Mercury. So both these artists have since passed. Coming out of the timeout here, Benedictine trying to get another back. Got Tristan Windham in goal for Kelvin. Here we go. On the attack. Benedictine. And taking the ball around the horn is Luke Grant. Finds Will Robinson trying to pinch in. Ground ball going to be scooped up there by Grant. Defended by Ryan Arn. We've got 10 on the shot clock. Time ticking down here on the Eagles. Trying to pinch in. Trying to get off a shot and a goal. With 3 on the shot clock. That was Will Robinson, who took his time and fired it home.
The Eagles' goal for Will Robinson. That's a hat trick for him.
So 12-7. Evan Rohde will come back in for the faceoff. Believe against Jonathan Zimmerman. It is. Rohde goes down, wins it, and scooped up by DeSarbo. DeSarbo coming right in on net, now behind the goal. Finds Blackman. 2:20 left in this one. On the carry, Ryan Westra. If I can spit that one out cleanly. Get my tongue tied. Loose ball picked up by DeSarbo. Pass goes wayward, trying to track it down. And still in play. So ground ball comes to Theodore Hollebeek. Blackman coming around the horn. 30 on the shot clock. Under 2 on the game clock. Ooh, getting knocked down to the ground. It'll be a crease violation, I believe, on Kelvin. Hollebeek got knocked off his feet and fell in the crease. So a clear attempt coming up for Benedictine. Jonathan Zimmerman, the faceoff specialist, carries it into the Kelvin zone. On the carry there is Schroeder. Now Will Robinson, who had a goal a moment ago, twisting, turning. Finds Luke Grant. Still in possession is Grant. Being tightly defended by Duncan Billings, who's into the game for Kelvin. That thing's going to be turned over. Billings, I think, causing the turnover, number 27. Well, we're going to have a penalty on Kelvin.
Penalty, Augie Bryan.
On August Bryan with 1:06 left. So another man-up opportunity. So Kelvin been penalized a little bit here in the second half and has taken some of the steam away down the stretch. That is Robinson again, now going around the horn. Benedictine being patient. A shot, and it's going to be deflected, I think, by the goalie. It was Sarna with a shot. 39 on the game clock, 33 on the shot clock. 6 second differential. Dylan Skura. Now Grant. Shot and a goal. Goal's going to go to Luis Hernandez. It'll be a man-up goal.
Luis Hernandez.
And right now we're giving the assist to Tyler Sarna. So 12-8 and some penalties late. Putting a slight little damper on this one, but time also running out on Benedictine. So it's like Kelvin's going to get its second win in a row. Face-off here, Evan Rohde and Zimmerman. And Rohde will flick it toward the sidelines. It'll go out of bounds, so Benedictine with one last gasp here. I'm not sure if that goes as a face-off win and then a turnover. Might be. Be a shot that's going to go wide with 3 on the clock. The Knights are just going to run this clock out and win this game 12-8. So there's the long bomb pass. It ends this game, and Kelvin moves to 6-3 on the year.
Final score at the end of the game.
A nice week, a one-goal win at Illinois Tech on Wednesday in the closing seconds, and then a 12-8 win over Benedictine. Second straight year the Knights have defeated the Eagles. Looking ahead to next week for Kelvin. Quickly, the Knights hosting the Cardinals of North Central next Saturday at 1 o'clock. Try to get you stats here real fast. Leading goal scorer was Will Robinson for Benedictine. He had two. Goal for Ben Zimmerman and Langley. See, on the Kelvin side, three goals for Blackman, three goals for Kohler, four for Carpenter, and one for Joshua Moyer, and one for Riley DeSarbo. Knights win at 12-8. Hey, I want to thank Justin Kendall for producing this game along with his fantastic student crew. We'll be back here a week from today against North Central. Till then, we say so long.
And now, till we meet again. Adios, au revoir.
And that's all, folks.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming. Please drive carefully and arrive home safely. Good night.